Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today I will going to tell you about the synchronous AM detector. So as we know, synchronous AM detector is in a device which is used to detect the amplitude modulated wave. So to understand the synchronous AM detector, we have a trainer kit whose order code is 40525. So this is Tesca's synchronous AM detector, and by using this kit we are going to perform the and detect the AM modulated wave, and in output we are going to also see the demodulated output. So to understand this, understand this synchronous AM detector, we required some apparatus. So this is a digital analog lab. Order code for this digital analog lab is 33503. So in this digital analog lab, I am going to use the function generator section. So in this training kit we provide an inbuilt function generator, so you can use this inbuilt function generator for carrier signal or a message signal. This is a CRO to observe the output of synchronous AM detector, and this is a function generator for generating the carrier frequencies or carrier sine wave. So now our first experiment for this synchronous AM detector is, this is a lab manual. So this is our first experiment to study and observe the working of an amplitude modulator. So to understand this experiment, this is a connection diagram given in the manual. So as per connection diagram, I am going to connect the connection in the training board, and this is a procedure given in the manual. So you have to read this procedure and connect the connection in the training board. So I am going to start reading the procedure. So connect the function generator 1 of 400 millivolt peak to peak and 2 kilohertz sine wave at a message input socket. So here, by using this 33503, I am going to give the 400 millivolt peak to peak and 2 kilohertz sine wave. So here, give it to the message signal and its ground terminal to the this ground terminal. Now we are going to observe the 400 millivolt peak to peak sine wave and 2 kilohertz frequency waveform in the message signal. So here the amplitude of the sine wave is should be 400 millivolt peak to peak. So here I have set it the amplitude of the sine wave 400 millivolt peak to peak, and I have to set the frequency at 2 kilohertz. So here frequency of the sine wave should be 2 kilohertz. So here I have set the message signal frequency at 2 kilohertz and amplitude of the sine wave nearby 400 millivolt. So this is the peak to peak of sine wave. Now connect the function generator 2 400 millivolt peak to peak and 100 kilohertz sine wave at a carrier input socket. So I will give the carrier signal using the function generator of a sine wave of 400 millivolt peak to peak and 100 kilohertz frequency. Here I have feed the carrier waveform in the VCT section. Now I will observe the sine wave of 400 millivolt peak to peak and 100 kilohertz frequency. So here, first of all, I am increasing the frequency till 100 kilohertz. So here we are having the 100 kilohertz. Now I have set the, I have to set the frequency amplitude 400 millivolt peak to peak. So here you can see the amplitude of the sine wave is nearby 400 millivolt peak to peak. Now connect the CRO at AM output terminal to observe the amplitude modulated waveform. So in output, this is a AM modulated waveform, and you can vary the carrier adjust to see the, to smooth the AM modulated waveform. So by varying this carrier adjust port, you have to verify the amplitude modulated waveform. Now connect the TP2 terminal to TP3 terminal and VCT of balance modulator first to the VCT of balance modulator second to observe the double modulated AM waveform. And now vary the carrier adjust to observe the double modulated AM waveform. So by varying the carrier adjust of balance modulator first and second, you can observe the double modulated AM waveform. So this is the double modulated AM waveform. So by this double modulated AM waveform, you can observe in the manual also, this is a modulated AM modulated waveform, and this one is double modulated AM waveform. Now we are going to observe the demodulated waveform, which is a sine wave that we have given in the message signal. Now to see this, remove the CRO pin. Now connect the TP5 terminal to TP6 terminal to observe the demodulated output. Now connect the CRO to TP7 terminal. So here you can see in output we getting the demodulated AM waveform. So this is a demodulated waveform, and you can increase the amplitude using the message signal, and you can see the variation in the demodulated waveform. So here the input message signal is of 1.4 volt peak to peak. So in demodulated we getting same thing. So this is all about this synchronous AM detector. So thank you for watching this video. For other queries, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.